So, got a rubik's cube. So, one second. I'm gonna mix it up. So, not why. Mixed it up. So you don't just go like this. Mommy, I've done it. Look, I'm complete. No. Well, you can do that. That's kind of just following the way that you've just messed it up. So in this video, I am not going to be using the algorithms. So sorry if you want that, but I find it easier without it, without rowing. R, I, F, stuff like that, because I don't know what they're talking about. So yeah, I've got normal Rubik's Cube like this. All Rubik's are normals, but yeah. But unlike this one, a cheaper one, a little bit bigger than this one, but has some other purple colours like that. So you've got the red, it's pink, and the colours are a little bit shabbier. Oops, that's, and then like the blue, and then you've got the white. The white's alright, but the yellow's like disturbing, and you've got like scratches all over it. So you're like, and then I've got the Rubik's white as well. And this one hasn't got white, it's changed white for purple somehow. So yeah, I only managed to complete that today using the algorithm for the 3x3. But yeah, that's a little bit smaller, and obviously it hasn't got the middle, so it's got like carved edges because of it. So we're going to be messing up this. Because usually you'll get your Rubik's Cube like completed like this one, but that wasn't. So yeah, that's messed up enough. People will tell you, oh, that's not the way to mess it up or whatever you want to. So I'm gonna use the orange side to mess up. Obviously you can use whatever side, but I find the orange easiest. So, like this white. So, I'll put it down and then get back to you when I've finished the orange side. So, completed. Not completed, like this one, but yeah, completed this. No. So, one thing I forgot to tell you, just in case you're new, you have to get all the colours right on the edge. So, now onto the second layer. So, the second layer, you've got to get your colours not the same as your bottom colour, and then line it up with the colour that's first up, and then you turn it the opposite way you'd want it, and then go like that. And so I'll show you properly now. So you go to the white like that, so that's going there, so you turn it this way, and then bring this side down, this side across, then bring it back up, then go like that, and bring that across, and bring that up. So yeah, very confusing. So so this has got to go to this side, so you turn it the opposite. So that way, bring this way down, bring that across, then bring that one back up, and then bring it back across, and then we'll turn that one down, across, and back up. Alright, so that's that one done. And then we got the last one to do, so let me quickly just do that one. So now to the bottom layer. First you've got to make a cross like that. So like that. So you'll go like this, you turn whatever colour you want to be on. I'll be on white, because and then go there. And then turn it that way. So you're turning it to your left. So if it's facing you, turn it to your left. And then you turn the right side up, turn the right side up, turn the top side back over, and so then you've got all the white together. Then turn this one back down, your right side back down, then like that, so then you've got that all completed, and then you've got a line across. So once you've got your line across, you turn it so it's not like that, so it's like got a thing. That's how I did it anyway. So you turn it there and then you do that move again. So that way, that way. And then you've got that one, so not quite done yet. So then you do it again. So now I've got this. Usually that would be there, but obviously not. So we go up on your right side, you go, you turn that up, then you turn the top to your left, then you bring your right back down, then top to the left, and then you bring your right side back up, and then turn your top twice, and then you go on there, and then you put that to your left side, then you do that same move again, so like that, then you have it like that, and then you turn it back to your left, you go up, down, round, up, round, round, down, and you've got your red completed. So let's say you have none of your corners completed, which I haven't. Then you have to use this move. So you go. Down. And then you go that way. Then you bring that up. Then you go twice across. Then you bring that back down. Then you go that, 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 back down. And then. Let's see, we've got these two corners completed. So you don't face them with the colour that they have to complete with. You turn it to the back. And then you be on the colour that's in front. And then you'll do that move again. So you've got that. One move. That one. 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 And then, in this case, not all completed, so. And then, after, you turn that up, turn that one, turn that one, turn that one, up, side out, and go that out, go that out. Still not completed, here's your middles. So you go, up like that, down, down, turn around, up, side, all the way down. You've got your Rubik's Cube completed, so you can get one of the a Rubik's Cube, and then they show I was going to put it on PlayStation, but it's kind of glitched a lot. So, yeah, we've got to sort that out. There we go. It's working now. Right, so. Leave in the comments where to find a Rubik's 4x4, because if I've completed the 3x3 and completed my brother's 2x2, I need to get another one of those for myself. And I've completed that one as well, Rubik's 4x4. I need to get me one. So, leave in the comments. Where to find a thingamabob?